The first thing to know when you are going to work in a workshop is the safety precautions. And when you are going to do some job on the workshop, the first thing you must know is what are the things I need to do before going near the machine. Whenever you are working on a machine, there are three things: the safety of your own self, the safety of the machine, for example, if I'm working on this vise, so the safety of this vise, and the safety of the environment, anything which is other than the machine and myself. So first of all, we talk about the personal safety. In the personal safety, you have to wear some equipment which is for your personal safety and protection from any hazards or risks. So we call that PPE, personal protective equipment. There are few items in front of you. For example, here we have the welding gloves. So for the protection of your hands, you must wear the specific corresponding gloves. If you are doing welding, you have to wear the welding gloves. If you are doing filing or fitting, you have to wear other work labor gloves. If you are going to pick up some heavy loads, you have to wear some specific gloves specified for that job. And then comes your eyes. If you are going to work on a machine like lathe machine or milling machine or any operation in which some particles can come into contact with your ear, or also if you are working with some chemicals and you don't want the chemicals enter your eyes and damage them, you must wear this side of ear. So it will help you, it will keep your eyes safe from the accidents. Then comes your head. So for head, you have to wear safety helmet. So this helmet helps you for anything hitting your head, or if you are working on some height or something is may fall from height. In both cases, you have to wear the helmets. So we have a crane here in mechanical workshop. So if you are going to operate that crane, you have to wear that helmet first. Similarly, there are more shields for the protection of face and eyes and mouth. This is, for example, a shield for welding. So when you are doing welding, you have to wear this for the protection of your eyes. It has specific standard shield for the protection of the spark which is coming into your eyes. This is another type of the helmet. So, or the shield. So you have to select specific shield for the type of welding you are going to do. The next thing is the earmuffs. So if the noise level is above a certain level, which is annoying for you, you may wear these earmuffs, which will help you for the protection of your ears. So if the noise is very much, you will wear that. Now we will show you worker who is going to work near the machine, and he will show you how to wear these all gears. Okay, so we have a machinist ready to work on the machine, and he has worn all of his protective gears. So he is going to work on filing. So for the filing, these are the items which are required, and additionally he is wearing a helmet. Helmet is for any hazard which is coming from the crane, because we have an operating crane in the workshop. Normally when the course is on, we don't have the workshop on, so we don't ask the students to wear helmets. Otherwise, helmet is recommended. This is the safety goggles. So these will help any birds. It will help protect his eyes from any birds or metal particles going into it. This should also be worn during lathe work or machining work or shaper work. For the welding, this will be replaced by a welding shield. For the face, there is no chemical going inside, that's why he is not wearing a mask. Otherwise, if there is some particles moving, flying in the air, the mask can be worn as well. Then for the protection of his clothes, and any hazard from his direct contact with the body, he is wearing the safety coat. Then we have the gloves. So for the protection of the hands, we have the working gloves here. And as I showed you earlier, if he is going to do the welding, he will wear the welding gloves. And then in the feet, he has to wear the safety shoes. So I am not going to work on the machine, that's why I am not wearing them. But he has to work on the machine, so he cannot go near the machine and start working until he has these specific standard safety shoes. So when you are going to start your work on the machine shop, you must know what are the personal protective equipment that has to be worn by you before working on that machine. So that's all from my side. If you have any further questions or comments, please let me know. Thank you.